My name is Chris Denney, and I work with Worthington Assembly and CircuitHub, and we're working on a special project for open source ventilators, and which is a really cool opportunity to design ventilators that anybody in the world can manufacture, but we're working on the initial prototypes. So I just want to give some background information. The team from all over the world did the design on this, and then they asked for donations from manufacturers such as ourselves, but also we got the circuit boards are manufactured by a company in Michigan called Calumet Electronics. And after they got the bare boards made, I reached out to DigiKey, and they generously donated thousands of dollars worth of parts, which was super killer of those guys to do that to the cause. So then we received all the parts just a couple days ago. The team came in over the weekend and worked on a day they don't normally work to try to put together all the kits and get them ready for us. So these are all the kits, so they were all put together. So each one of these bins here is dedicated to a specific circuit board. There's five different circuit boards. We've already gotten started on one of them. And so all those kits are ready. We know we have the parts we need in order to build them. Here's all the circuit boards. Now these were jet printed by our jet printer rather than using stencils, so we could save on tooling costs. So if you you can get a good shot of that there, you can see how little tiny dots of solder paste was deposited all over those boards so that they're ready to have surface mount components placed on them. So these boards are ready to be run. We're gonna run these this afternoon, probably this morning and this afternoon. Which is pretty exciting. So those are the four circuit boards. There's a fifth one already on the line. And now that the parts are all kitted, they're going to get set up so that we can run them on our pick and place machine. And that setup is done over here. So we have a series of feeders which go into these magazines. So here's a feeder, and you can see how the part gets loaded into there, and the cover tape gets folded over by this little plow here, this plow section. So that's how they get loaded up and they get ready for the pick and place machine. It takes a little bit of time, but once those are ready, we'll be able to pick and place parts onto the circuit board. We have the boards in our pick and place machine. So this is clamped in, and so how this will work is this table moves in one direction, and then there's another motor that moves in the opposite direction. And the two come together to pick parts and place parts. So now I'm going to hit run. And it will begin to do some initialization stuff and pick parts and then place those parts onto the board. Okay, so we finished. These are the motherboards here, and they've gone through our pick and place machine. So all these components are sitting in the solder paste. They're wet. In other words, they're not solid solder joints yet. So if I was to touch any of these components, it would move. And so now to solder them all together, we're going to put them into our high mass reflow oven here. And we're going to put these in by hand because it's such a small volume, but we do have a conveyor that can load them automatically. But now it's going to go in the oven, and 8 minutes later, they'll come out with solder joints. Alright, so then after they come through reflow, they partially cool down inside the oven, but they're still quite warm when they get here. So this long belt lets them cool down a little bit more. It also happens to catch the boards so that they don't just fall out of the oven. And now everything's soldered, so nothing is moving when I touch it. And now they're ready for our automated optical inspection process. So now we're going to do AOI process on this, automated optical inspection. That's what this machine's for. So we're going to barcode it so we can keep track of it. Put it in the board holder. And now the machine will take a bunch of pictures, and the computer will analyze those pictures to make sure that everything is correct, point out any issues. So now we're going to do the through-hole parts, and so the first board, we're just using this partially built panel, and all these parts just get inserted by hand. So literally you just
All the parts get inserted by hand, just like that. They get inserted offline, and then they come over here to actually get the soldering done. So this is called a selective soldering machine. We have a little fixture here that holds the board in place. And then there's a fountain of solder right here that is mounted on top of a robot, which will walk around and solder this whole board. So the first thing that happens is it's going to eject a little tiny stream of flux all over the bottom of the parts here. So you hear a small buzzing sound as it walks up and down these various parts to make sure that they all get flux. And the flux is important because otherwise you can't get a good solder joint. It's an acid designed to break down the oxidized layer of stuff on the copper and on the tin. And then once it's treated with the flux, then the nozzle of solder will come over and actually perform all the soldering. So now it's going to begin to walk over all those parts and solder everything. So after it comes out of the selective solder machine, all these through-hole parts are soldered into place, and you have all these beautiful shiny solder joints on the bottom, all done automatically with the machine. Now we're going to inspect the board just to make sure that all the parts are looking good, solder joints are looking good, check anything that the AOI may have reported. Check everything else that the AOI couldn't see, because there are certain parts it can't see. And if there's any final touch-up, that'll be done over here before we go to depanelize this. Now we have to depanelize this because it's in a panel with three boards. Even though we're not building these two, we still have to separate the one from the other two. So that's what this does. We have a sharp knife on the bottom and we have a rolling blade on the top. And there's a V groove that this sets into. So we'll set it into that V groove. We'll draw this blade across, and that'll separate them. So then there's also some rails on the outside we have to do as well. I'm gonna flip this over. It's safer to do it this way. This side. This final side has to be done by hand, because this USB port is hanging over the edge. So we'll have to break this final side off by hand. And there we go. Okay, so now we're gonna put it inside of our light box to take a picture, because we like to document at least one sample of everything we build. So we have a little light box here. Turn that on. And now, this board is ready to be shipped. Once we get all the other ones done, we'll pack them all together and send them to the folks to go into the final assembly.
And before we go, I just quickly wanted to give a big thanks to Chris Denney for giving us that really awesome tour. And I also wanted to thank all the people that donated their time and resources towards making this project come to life. And if you'd like to learn more about the Open Source Ventilator Project, you can check out opensourceventilator.ie. And if you're curious about what CircuitHub does and you'd like to learn more, you can check out CircuitHub.com. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.